The great thing about proteins is that they have a very high thermic effect. This means a large amount of the calories which come from proteins get metabolized by our body. And if we overeat on the proteins, not much will be stored as body fat. And if you want to get lean and lose body fat, then this is a great effect that you can benefit from. But this isn't the topic of this video. In this video, I actually want to talk about the five most filling protein sources, which will help you to lose body fat, get lean, build muscle, and just look great without a shirt on. These are the protein sources which helped me personally to get into the best shape of my life. And I can tell you guys, these protein sources are still delicious, very nutritious, of course, low calorie, and also very cheap. Sadly, many people aren't talking about them, and they aren't very common in the fitness and bodybuilding industry. But after watching this video, you'll know exactly why these protein sources are so good, so filling, and you have a reason to start implementing them into your diet. Now, let's right away start analyzing what makes a protein source not filling, and there are mainly two things. Either it's low in volume or it is high in fat. Those are the two things which make the protein sources very high calorie, and therefore we won't be able to eat loads of it and still lose body fat. And oftentimes, when a protein source is higher in calorie, it also doesn't have more proteins. Therefore, it just doesn't make sense to go for options like this if you want to lose body fat and still feel full after a meal, because that's the key for successfully achieving a fat loss transformation. You need to be full after eating your meals, and that's when now the five protein sources I'm going to talk about get into their place. Right away, starting with the first one, which are shrimps. This is a hugely underrated protein source. I mean, we almost never see bodybuilders or people in the fitness industry eating shrimps, even though they are very low in calorie and high protein. So we can eat loads of them, still not consume loads of calories, but stack up on the proteins and easily hit our protein target. Because 100 grams of shrimp have less than 100 calories, but more than 20 grams of protein. These are better macros than a chicken breast. And I mean, most people are already bored of the normal chicken breast, so they are happy if there are different options, like for example the shrimps, who have a different taste and actually have even better macros. Then also right away moving on to the second one, which is also a seafood, and it is white fish. Here it's very important to mention that it should be white fish, because other fish, like for example salmon, is very high calorie. Now, I'm not saying that salmon is a bad food. I'm personally eating it on a regular basis because it has very healthy fats, which are good for us. But still, if you're counting macros and are really on a low-calorie diet to get as shredded as possible, then salmon might not be the best option because for the calories it has, it doesn't give you a lot of proteins. That's why white fish is a game changer. This oftentimes also has less than 100 calories per 100 gram, but still is in the range of 20 grams of protein. Just like chicken or other meats. That's why this is also a great option if you like seafood but still want to get your proteins in. Great, then already moving on to the third one, which is turkey. Here I need to say it's important to choose a lean turkey because there are certain companies who sell turkey who also has some fat in it. Then it right away has the double amount of calories. But if you're able to get a piece of a lean turkey, then you will get even more proteins in your system for fewer calories than chicken breast. So as you can see, chicken breast actually isn't even the best protein source if you want to cut down, get lean, and save your proteins. But still, if you're someone who maybe likes the taste of chicken but isn't happy with the macros, then turkey is a great way to still get the same taste but just better macros. Great, now moving on to the fourth one, which is quite controversial, and many people will comment down below that this isn't a great option because it's the eggs. Here, let me explain you why I actually took this into this list and why it personally helped me loads with losing body fat but still saving my proteins. The thing is, yes, eggs actually have loads of calories. So only one large egg has around about 80 calories. And I mean, if you want to get like 30 grams of protein, you'll have to eat 5 or 6 of them, which right away brings you up to 400 or 500 calories. But the reason why they are actually so helpful for cutting body fat is because you can, for example, make an omelette and throw multiple things in there. You can throw all of the vegetables, the greens, whatever you want to in there, and then it's a huge meal and it's very filling. This is so good about the eggs. They just combine so many foods together and create a very filling meal. This is, for example, a meal I have almost every night. Because it is a bit higher in fats, it also keeps me full for a long time. This is kind of the problem with the other protein sources I've mentioned. They are filling at the moment, but a few hours later, I oftentimes get hungry again because they're so low in fats. That's why some eggs at the end of the day is a great option to make sure that you're full throughout the whole night, can sleep very well, and optimizes your body for fat loss. Perfect. Now moving on to the fifth one, the last one, which is skyr. Now, I've already talked loads about this food on this channel. And for those who don't know yet, this is very similar to Greek yogurt. So it has almost the same macros. It just has a sweet taste to it because it has some artificial sugar in there. Now, this is a topic for a different video, if artificial sugar is good for you or not. But I can tell you, it definitely helped me to satisfy my sweet tooth without having any calories. And the good thing about skyr is that it has great macros. Most of the skyrs out there have 10 grams of protein per 100 gram and only about 50 or 60 calories. So if you want to have your 20 grams of protein in a meal, then about 120 calories of skyr will give you this. And for this, again, you can make very filling meals by just adding some fruit and multiple things in there. My favorite one is skyr with, for example, some watermelon or some pineapple. These are two fruits which are also very low in calorie but very filling, which overall creates just an amazing meal with great macros, which ensures you that you will be able to lose body fat effortlessly. Perfect. So those are my top 5 protein sources which help me to lose body fat because they are so filling and low in calorie. Now, if you aren't eating those protein sources on a regular basis, then I can recommend you to start implementing them into your diet plan because they are really a game changer. Before I knew about those foods, I was starving myself. I didn't feel full after a meal when I was in a fat loss phase. And for those who have already experienced this, they know how bad this is. You won't be able to stick to your diet like that and you will end up binge eating like most people. But with those foods, you will be able to actually successfully finish your diet and get the results that you wanted to get. Now, if you don't know how you can actually start implementing them into your diet, I have linked a free diet plan down in the description that you can have access to. With this diet plan, I was able to get the leanest version of myself. And if you stick to it, you'll be able to achieve that as well. Now, thank you for watching this video till the end. If you enjoyed it and found it helpful, I would appreciate it a lot if you would like and subscribe.